Hello to all my BPTV fans, YouTube fans, and new fans. I'm Alan Levine, the Talking Machine. I'm here today to film my 14th Speedy Gourmet show on a hot 94 degree high, heading for our 96 degree record. We got the AC on for my camera crew, so I'm nice and chilly here. We're gonna start the timer right now. I got some Mahi Mahi steak, wild caught. You can see this. And I prefer the wild caught over farm raised fish. It's much healthier and you don't have all the mercury and bad ingredients in it and pesticides and you name it. I'm gonna get a couple vegetables out. A little surprise, never tried. Purple asparagus. Look at the color of that. So we're gonna look at doing that. My trusty thermometer my daughter got me. Thanks, Casey. And my rice cooker for the microwave. 22 years ago I got this in 2000. And it still works. All right, let me get my Cutco knife out. My niece was selling these 30 years ago or 25 years ago to my dad. He had an extra one. And I just do a little slice. And yes, I don't cut like they do on TV with stuff, but I watch my fingers. And we'll rinse off the Mahi Mahi. Little rinse here. I'll set it down and we'll come back to get it. All right, we got a few things going on here. Let me go into my pantry. You know, I like my ancient grains. Here's farro. It's ancient grains. You can read the label. And I got this at Fresh Time. And we're gonna use that for our rice cooker. And you can follow this. I'm just trying to show you how easy it is. Take the rubber band off the top one. And I'm gonna pull out like four of them. Look how purple these are. And I'll get this out of the way. Excuse me for a minute while I disappear. All right. Rice cooker's gonna come out here. Box back there. I've been doing it so long. Here's what it looks like. Get the measuring cup and the spoon for getting it out when it's done. So we'll get to that in a minute. Let me rinse off the asparagus. Give it a good rinse. Dry it a little, set it on the side. Give you a little cut, my secret with asparagus. I cut about the bottom inch off of it, toss them out. Other opening, look at this ceramic pot here. Put some water in, as you can see, and I stand the asparagus up in here and we'll get ready to cook on that in a while. Baking tray. We're gonna use that. We're setting the table for everything there, guys. Let's get the farro. Get the steady hand here. Fill it up. I like a little extra, so I fill it up a little bit above. And I try to clean up as I'm going, so pardon me again. Farro in the cabinet. Here's what we do, dump it. Get like 1.5 of these for the water. All right. Now, here's the trick. I use some vegetables, and we just happen to have some zucchini. We'll rinse that. Yellow squash. We'll rinse these also. All right, we're ready for some cuts. Cut the top off. Cut about maybe 4 or 5. Guess what? Toss them right in there. Zucchini now. Five's my lucky number today. 5 more of that. Then we got some fresh broccoli. I'm gonna cut a couple of them off. One there. Oh, and another one here. They're trying to run away. We're gonna throw these in there too, because it steams it. It's a steamer. And I like my steamed veggies. You know, I like a lot of them. So here's what we'll do. We'll split it here. One. Let's split it again. And we'll try again, and magic number of 5. Here's what it looks like. And we're gonna go put it in the microwave for 11 minutes. So let's see what we can do. Some broccoli. All right, we're gonna start it there. All right. Olive oil cooking spray adds a little flavor of it. I have my other virgin olive oil that I use on the meal. Spray it down. Here we go with our mahi. Mahi. Position that there. And I like my Bella mushrooms. And you can see I got a few of them here. We'll rinse them, because they have a lot of stuff on them. So take the stems out, rinse them. And I'll bring it back here again. We'll move these to the side. That. I gotta dry up a little bit here. Splashed up a little. All right, here we go. A little tough to slice that. Moving on me. That's how simple it is. And I like my mushrooms, as you can see. And what we do is, see how you can just do this? Just put them on there. I don't have a lot to bake today. So I'll put some here, there, and I turned my electric oven on to 465. It's a little warmer than what you have to do as a gas oven, so check it out. The electric's not as efficient as gas, believe it or not. So we're gonna put that right into the oven. There we go. Thank you for getting a close-up on that. We're gonna turn up the water, and we'll let this boil for 5 or 6 minutes to have it nice and tender. And they told me at Fresh Time that it's a delicious asparagus. So we'll put this back in, and we'll put all these veggies back, and we'll put that in the refrigerator. Let me get these out of the way. Let's see what we got. 1, 2, 3, 4. We're good on that. Got everything. Everybody knows I like to use my tea. We'll bring it over. I'm going with one of my favorites. Again, for over 20 years. Well, we got to do a little rinse here first. Throw this. Scrape this off. Then we'll rinse it up like I'm doing here. Again, we're making Mahi Mahi. Wild caught Mahi Mahi. Put the board here. We'll work off of it. For all the penguin fans, there's our penguin, there's our cup. Get my trusty teaspoon out. You need a steady hand there, and I'll try to provide that. Oh, couple little leaves fell off. We'll try to put them in there. 1 teaspoon. That's all I need for my cup of tea. Sometimes I can get a second use out of it. Here's how simple it is. Put it on the top where there's a little nub. Then you close it up. Whoop, flip it over. Look how it closes up. And then it'll be right here waiting for my gift my daughter gave me, a Cuisinart 175 green tea, and you start it up. You'll hear it rumbling. Might as well get the thermometer out. We'll get ready to use that. And we need about 145 on the temp of the fish. So we'll put that there. Put this back. Rinse off the knife. Set it there till further use. And if you can see, I repurposed multi peppers that I had in here for, you know how you put black and rainbow peppers on a meal, like in here. Well, this is where I get it to put in there. And I used it because it keeps my tea for months and months on end very fresh. So we'll set this up for when the tea is ready. You'll hear a little beep on it. Spoon for later. We can put this to dry. I guess we need a plate. 1 plate. 1 fork. I usually forget these, but my silicone handy gloves, you don't get burnt in the oven. So we'll put these out there to use there. And let's check the timer here. Wow, we're about 12 minutes into this, and we usually do it under 25. So we look like we're on a good pace. Let me check. Water here is not boiling yet, but we'll get there. 5 minutes on the rice, if you want to pull a close up on there. And we got this cooking. And the oven will give you a little peek. Whoa, a little bit of smoke there. And we'll check that in a few minutes. So stay tuned to that. And the farro's an ancient grain from Italy that they've been using for years. And I have a couple others. We used pearl barley the last show, which is a favorite of mine. And this is just how you can eat it healthy. And let me wipe this down again. All right, we'll leave that there for other business. I throw out the stems. Here's the stems from the mushrooms. That's the last you'll see of the Mahi Mahi. And prices of fish, along with everything else, are a bit off, out of control. But hey, this is the life we have right now. And here's my deal of the day. I'm going to have a dessert today. I don't always put it up there. But I love my fruit. Blackberries, I got at Fresh Thyme for 99 cents. I like my deals. And then raspberries from Aldi's, 149. So their blackberries were like 279, so Fresh Thyme helped me out. Let's see. Get a handy little plate. I'll set it here, and you can watch. I'll rinse off what I'm going to eat, about a handful. And that'll be for dessert. And you can hear the rumbling of the water. It's supposed to just get ready to boil. So if you don't, if you're going to boil it on your own for a temperature without putting a thermometer in. And then here's our little presentation of dessert. All right. And I found out that you don't have to put a lot of veggies and fruit in the refrigerator. In America, somehow we put everything in the refrigerator. So I've been leaving my stuff out, peaches, yellow squash, and zucchini, and they don't go bad any quicker. It's about the same. And they don't get chilled up, so they're always good and ready to cook. Yeah, we got, that's getting warm there. And let me just check on where we're at here. Yep, our asparagus. Water is getting warmer. Look at how big they are. Look at these guys. I'm used to about 1/4 of the size, because I found out with asparagus, the more tender they are, is the thinner they are. So when they come out, the thick ones that they have that are green, they're always a little too tough and not as tasty. But they told me the purple ones are very sweet. So I can't wait to try them. I've never had them until today. So it's a Speedy Gourmet first for purple asparagus. Oh, we're down to the last minute and 34 and counting. So we're moving forward here, guys. And to all my fans, you can appreciate I got a couple minutes. Not much I can really do right now, except to tell you thank you for all the great feedback. Thank you for the comments. And I'm wearing shorts. And yes, I have my socks on with no shoes. This is my humble kitchen. So I feel at home and comfortable. Don't have to really dress up for you extra. But this is part of what we're doing. We'll give a little quick wipe here. Even though it's warm outside, it's cool in here. So things aren't drying any faster like they would outside. And you can hear this is like right before a boil. It's interesting. You can hear it rumbling. All right. And we'll get some peppercorns ready. We need to get, let's see. We have fresh ginger, just bought the other day. You can see you get the ginger root. I put it on every meal. It's so healthy, helps you many ways, and even with digestion. And we'll get my handy shredder ready to go. There we go. So we're just setting it up. What you can do is just go step by step and set it up. All right, we got some action here, folks. I'm gonna bring it to you. I'll bring it to you and we'll head to the table there. And let me be careful, it's hot. And we'll give you a look at the steam. Hence, look at the steamed veggies in there. Very tasty. We'll leave it in for a minute or so. And then we'll start putting it on the plate. I'm gonna do a little check of the oven and the thermometer to see what we have going on here. Well, let me get a little. The tea's ready. We got everything going on. There, we'll see. Wow. Mahi Mahi is ready. We might just do a little flip on it. Let me get my spatula. Do a little flip. Watch the finger. Wow, we're heated up. Scrape off a little of the fat. All right, we'll leave that in. And our mushrooms, we have mushrooms. We're gonna use this throughout the meal. I love the Bella mushrooms, just a great flavor. And I've even made Bella mushroom sandwiches. All right, so we'll just put this on a minute. I'll shut the oven down. And we have tea. Let's go to the tea. I always pull the plug out, but it does keep it warm for another cup or two. And here's what we do. That's how simple it is. Look at the steam coming up from it. hot to the touch. And we'll set this right over here. Let's bring the plate over. I'll go and get it. All right. And we'll put the farro there. And I like to separate my vegetables with the look that I give them. And we'll try to get that out there for you. And we do mix things up a little bit. Veggies are a little congealed there. Zucchini. Look at this broccoli, how tender. What do I got? My magic number 5. So another couple broccoli. I like my veggies. One more piece of broccoli. Zucchini coming at you. And the mushrooms, we're going to mix them up throughout the meal. So just stay tuned for that. And we'll save some space for the asparagus. All right. Yellow squash. All right. Let's just scoop it out here and you'll see what I have. This is farro, the ancient grain. It's been around for thousands of years, so give you a little history about agrarian societies. People started domesticating it thousands of years ago. And that's what we do. We put it out there and we'll put a few mushrooms there. And we'll just move because we'll put asparagus over there. Got a few mushrooms here and I'll put them on the fish. We better get that fish, right? All right, here we go. All right, and we'll do a little trick here. You stay right there with the camera. I'm gonna get the plate. And we'll maneuver a few things. Here's our Mahi Mahi. Look at that, almost centered in the plate. We're getting down to it, folks. Look at that. And I like to get my empty spaces closed up a little. And I'll put a couple of the mushrooms on there for how it looks and presentation. And thanks for all of you appreciating my presentations. You can see how simple it is to do. And we should be ready with the asparagus. And they're a little hot right now. So I'll see if I can handle it. Yeah. Wow, look at the color there. First time for the talking machine to eat purple asparagus for you. Look, they stack up beautiful. And look at that, water's all boiled up and out. We'll give it a dump. Let this cool off. Little rinse. All right, now we have some Greek Kalmenna extra virgin olive oil. And I'll sprinkle this all over the meal. This is like my Mediterranean diet. And all of you that know that, olive oil, virgin olive oil is very good. One zucchini danced off of there. We'll get them. All right. Set it there. Rainbow peppercorns. Just for a little flavor. And part of the presentation. Are you ready? Ginger is ready to be there. We got, look at the loose leaf green tea, China gunpowder. Look at how the color changed. It's a greenish color and it's very good. Light grassy flavor, which I like. And we're gonna get this ginger right now all over it. You can see it's easy to shred up, very fresh. There we go. That is it. Stop the timer. Well, thank you for watching the Speedy Gourmet today, our 14th show. Look at this presentation. I'll give it a little spin to you. Let me put the penguin on here so he looks good. And we got our China gunpowder, black raspberries, blackberries, and red raspberries. Sorry, I misspoke on that. Very delicious for after this. First time ever drinking, eating my purple asparagus. Mahi Mahi is a great like steak. It's a very thick, nutritious meal. And we got zucchini, we got the Bella mushrooms, we got yellow squash, broccoli, and we got it all here just for you. And that's it, 24:31 for the time. We beat 25 minutes today, so we're back on schedule. Thank you for all your great feedback and great comments. And some of you are even trying to eat fish now, just 2 times a week. Just have it there. And look how healthy it is and how easy it was to present to you. I'm honored to be doing this each week. And stay tuned for next month when Lucky 15 comes out.